Hello, and thanks for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. If you're returning, thanks, it means a lot. I really do read all the comments and try to reply to everybody, so I really appreciate it. Today we're gonna look at how to tune an engine, specifically a Honda motor on HTS, Honda Tuning Suite. This happens to be version 2.08. This is the pre-K series version, so I'm not tuning a K series. And they're all about the same, so this you can go off of this if you're using a K series. Once you open HTS, you're going to be presented with a blank screen like this. You can set up how you want it to display. I believe there's different windows. I like this personal one like this. It's much easier. This is what I learned on. So you're going to go to File, and you want to create a new base ROM. So right here, you can name your base ROM. We'll just name this one for the video purposes, D16Z6. There's not much support for OBD0 ECUs, ton for OBD1. So we'll click on OBD1, we'll go to version 1.15, and you're presented with a base map creator here. You can select what map sensor you have. For this purpose, we'll leave it stock. You can select your injector setup. 240 is a common Honda injector setup. You can come here and select your ohms based off what injectors you're running. So if you change your injectors, let's say to 440, and you hit enter, it's gonna ask if you wanna calculate the tip in and the trim. Yes, you do. And we're gonna go back to previous here, and you see it's taken out 45% upon startup. Now 440, we know our common Acura RDX. So let's find that down here and let's just change the value. And if you had stock injectors, you would just leave it alone, stock 240, and find which Honda ones you're running, 92 to 2000, or in the older Hondas and CRX to 86 to 91. They are different ohms, so make sure you know what injectors you have in there. Let's look for RDX injectors. Where are they? I know they're in here. Ah, here we are. So 440, 12 ohm. And then transmission, it gives you a few options. I just leave it on the Del Sol one, manual transmission. You can rescale for boost. For this video, we won't. Well, this is just creating your little base map. If you have a boosted car that you're starting a base map with, just click it and it'll rescale everything. And then you can set up your boost cut. You know, if you want the boost to cut at 10 PSI, 12 PSI, 8 PSI, whatever. This will give you some more columns and everything. So down here, you want to disable O2 because if you're going to start tuning, you need a wideband O2 sensor. It's not going to happen with a narrow band or stock O2 sensor. So at this point, you know, if you don't have an O2, you're shooting in the dark. So I leave all this stuff disabled personally. That's going to be preference and choice on you. So we're going to go to next. Now here, you're going to select what type of engine you're running. So D16Z6, VTEC is enabled, and that's when VTEC kicks on, and that's your rev limit, so we'll leave that alone for this video. And there you go, it generates a base map. So there's a couple things that I like to do personally. I'll click on the low cam ignition, and I'll come over here, and you see how jagged this is. Like all this stuff is very jagged right here. There's an auto smooth button here. So it will smooth that current map, and you see the jump that it made right here. Everything kind of smoothed out. We'll do that one more time, and smooth that one more time. Make sure while you're in each low cam, high cam, low fuel, high fuel, there's primary and secondary tables and maps. So we're still in low ignition. We're gonna go to the secondary map, and look, it's just as jagged. So we wanna do the same thing, clear it up. Boom, you're gonna smooth it. Go to your high cams map, do the same thing. Nice and smooth. Make sure you hit both of them. Fuel, the same thing. You see how jagged that fuel is right there? We're gonna smooth it. And then we're gonna go to the secondary map. See this spike right here? Go ahead and smooth that out. smooth out a little bit. Doesn't do it greatly. This one here, this spike here, let's smooth it out. You see how much it jumped back in? Same thing on the secondary, oh, I'm sorry, primary table. Okay, now that you've smoothed out all your ignition and fuel maps, you can come over to parameters and set things in your main settings. In this setting here, I leave the idle air control valve on because my vehicle has one. Depending on if you have one or not, you can disable it. I always disable the transmission and the traction control. Down here is used for kind of if you're experimenting. I leave all those unchecked because all the crank position sensor and all that stuff, you know, doesn't really apply to the P28. Idle settings, so your target idle after warm up, something you have to pay attention to. So your exhaust coolant temperature here, I believe, is in maybe in Fahrenheit now. So at 177, you're sitting at 850. No, this 286. So yeah, you're at 800. So it'll go down. You can change your base idle here. Let's say you know, your target idle is 1,000 because you got a big cam. Well, if you leave this at 850, it's going to go down to 850. So you'd have to come here and go 1,000, 1,000. And then here, I would just bring up to 900 and leave it at 900. I leave the idle air control valve error. I leave it enabled because my vehicle has one. If yours doesn't, make an educated guess. VTEC settings. This is where you can enable the VTEC. You can lower and enable the high and low. At what TPS threshold and inches of mercury it comes on at, and the minimum coolant temperature and speed you have to have, which coincides with the options. So speed check, temp check, pressure check, error check. So I always enable back the pressure check because if, this, so speed check will disable if you have a VVS issue or anything like that. Temp check is your coolant pressure temperature or your coolant temperature sensor. And either of those will produce an error. So the VTEC is looking, the computer is looking to see all these parameters are correct before it allows this to happen at this RPM. So I don't care about speed. I don't care about temp. I do care about oil pressure. Because if oil pressure is too low, you could end up destroying your lost motion. Your camshaft could get wear, extra wear on it. So I like to leave that enabled. Rev limits, this is just setting your cold and warm settings, whether you know you want fuel cut or ignition cut. So I kind of just leave that alone if you're just starting to tune. Here's your shift light. Let's say you want to shift before red line at 7300 or so. What'll happen is when you get to 7300 around there, because the gauge is not terribly accurate, the check engine light will come on. That's just letting you know to shift. And then once you shift and the RPM's lower, you're gonna end up being able to, that light will basically turn off, essentially. And then when you hit that RPM again, it'll turn back on. So you can enable it by gear. So first gear, 8,000. Let's say second gear, you're gonna leave it there. Third gear, you wanna shift a little earlier, 7,500. Fourth gear, 7,500. And fifth gear, you wanna wind all the way out. Whatever you wanna do, you can enable it. And then you're gonna come to, here you get your closed loop. This is where the O2 sensor is disabled. And like I said, you need a wideband O2 to do this. Your map sensor with stock. TPS sensor, that's a big one. So in this situation, you'd have to be hooked to the car, whether it be through some type of data logging, emulator, Cobra, you know, whatever's out there right now, Hondata. So, you know, I like to enable this. Well, not enable this. Once the ECU is connected, you can calibrate your TPS to what your actual pedal reading is, because sometimes they're slightly off and they may need adjustment. And that can affect the whole range of things like fuel, delivery, you know, how much your throttle plate is actually open, how much air CFM is coming into the engine. So that's a big one. So make sure you calibrate that always. Fan control, you can, when if you have stock fans, most people who are tuning and have built engines don't have a stock fan. Like myself, I have a separate fan controller, so I don't, you know, I disable that. I don't let the ECU control that. I control that off a whole separate controller. However you have it controlled, if you have your stock fans, leave it enabled, and you can change, you know, what temperature you want it to come on at. And once you got all that set up, that's about your basic base map. So you can come here and you can basically save as and do whatever you want, you know. Save it in their D16Z6 file. It's going to be a .bin file. So after that, that's what you would take that file and you would upload it on your SST chip or basically in your emulator. And that's how you would load it to your ECU and you'd be able to start your car. And once you start your car and warm it up, you'd be reading the wideband and you make your adjustments off that. So the next video, I'll actually talk about what tuning options you have and how to actually emulate to the car, see live data through your CN2 data port. So this video right here was just designed to basically get you a base map and get the car started. So stay tuned for the next videos. I appreciate it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.